Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Welcome back to the Alex Jones Show. I'm David Knight. I'm going to be joined in the next segment by Dr. Peter Bregan, and he's someone who's spoken out many times on the effects of SSRI drugs as that being the major common link in all of these mass shootings and suicides. It's why we call them murder pills here. We're also going to be talking to him about the effects of the potential for abuse with the brain project that Obama is coming up with the research that DARPA is doing, where they say that they want to selectively take out memories of people. That ought to raise everybody's fears. Now, of course, they say they're doing it for a good cause. They're going to use that to get rid of PTSD in veterans. But we've heard that before. We heard that after World War II. They were giving veterans lobotomies en masse in the 1950s. There was a massive exposure of that by the Wall Street Journal. It was also carried by PBS. I think it was Frontline that carried it. But there was a massive exposure of the atrocities that were committed on veterans by the VA in the name of helping them with PTSD, called lobotomies. And Dr. Bregan has been very much involved with that. He fought against the reinstitution of lobotomies as they were people were trying to bring that back in the 1970s. So I want to get his take on this new high-tech lobotomy and the potential for abuse, not only against veterans, but against the population in general. We were talking in the last segment to Paul Joseph Watson from the UK about this article that has been posted up on Infowars.com, where Border Patrol Vice President says cartels are using de facto amnesty to smuggle whatever they want and whoever they want into the United States. What is that going to bring into the United States? How is our government going to react to that? Of course, we see that the same organization, Homeland Security, that has opened up the borders, completely allowing anyone and anything to come in, as he points out, we see how, at the same time, they're militarizing towns in Florida, small towns, where there's been no crime, and yet they're giving them massive counterinsurgency equipment. They've been doing this for quite some time. They've been storing up ammunition for quite some time. It's almost like they were planning this. It's almost like they knew this was coming along. And of course, in this interview, and we're going to be talking to Staff Sergeant Joe Biggs about that, and there's some additional information that's not in this article that's going to be coming up. We're going to talk to him in the third hour from El Paso. He's there at the border. But in this interview that's up there now, this Border Patrol agent says that, of course, the economic conditions and the crime conditions are horrible there in Central America. But he goes, that's been going on for more than 10 years. He says, so this invasion, to start suddenly happening, something else had to change. And what changed is the fact that we're engaging in this catch-and-release program, and the word has spread fast. And so that's exactly what we see happening. But, of course, you know, Obama is now trying to step back a little bit as people are talking about how dangerous this is for the children. And, of course, that's another aspect of it. It's not just the demographic surge. It's not just the Cloward and Piven surge. But it's also the fact that they're deliberately bringing in young children. I believe that has to do with Obama's idea that he wants some kind of a youth corps. He wants to give them a free education and in return turn them into foot soldiers for the state, who are completely indoctrinated by the federal government, have no attachment to America or its traditions or even to their family. Their only attachment being to the federal government that they see as family, as mother, as father, as rich uncle. Listen to what he had to say about bringing the children in.
The problem is that under current law, once those kids come across the border, there's a system in which we're supposed to process them, take care of them, until we can send them back.
So is your message, don't come?
Oh, our message absolutely is don't send your children unaccompanied on trains or
not through, the same thing
through a bunch of smugglers. That is our direct message to the families in Central America. Do not send your children to the borders. If they do make it, they'll get sent back. More importantly, they're not sending them back, though.
And do you notice how he prevaricated around the truth when Stephanopoulos said, is your message?
Man, when I get home from work, all Betty does is watch her reality TV, and then she goes to sleep. I can take her on romantic dates. I get her flowers. You name it. She's just not the woman I married.
Oh, Ralph, that's just awful.
Does this seem familiar? Are the honeymoon days of your relationship long gone? If so, consider this. The abundance of chemical additives, pesticides, BPA containers, contaminated tap water, and other toxic substances found in our environment. Experts know our bodies are suffering and being thrown off balance, especially when it comes to your natural systems. Forget synthetic chemicals. Super Female Vitality brings forward key herbs specifically chosen for women's biology without the use of phony additives. Get your bottle of Super Female Vitality today at InfoWarsLife.com, InfoWarsStore.com, or call 1-888-253-3139. InfoWarsLife.com. Live life healthy.
A chemical spill contaminating the water supply in 9 West Virginia counties.
This year alone, over 300,000 people in West Virginia had their drinking water contaminated.
What are the health effects of having these drugs in our drinking water?
It's forced medical treatment without the consent of residents.
My friends, water filtration is one of the most basic actions you can take to protect you and your family from the harmful toxins and heavy metals in your tap water.
On average, the county says it sprays with glyphosate at least once a week.
Few filters cut out the glyphosate that is found in water supply worldwide. Remove pesticides, herbicides, chloramines, hydrofluorosilicic acid, sodium hexafluorosilicate.
Fluoride, it is in tea, it's in coffee, it's in water, it's in bread, it's in toothpaste.
It is our responsibility to protect our families. The establishment's not going to do it. It's time to take action. It's time to filter our water. Visit InfoWarsStore.com and use promo code WATER to get 10% off their entire family of incredible products. Or call toll free 888-253-3139. From the water table to our soils to the atmosphere itself, our world is becoming more and more toxic each and every day. But it's not just the air outside that's toxic. Indoor air has been shown to have 2 to 5 times higher concentrations of pollutants than even outdoor air. And most Americans spend 90% of their time inside using toxic chemicals within their homes. There are more than 42 million smokers in the United States, well over 1,000 types of mold and mildew linked to numerous conditions. And don't forget the fact that 6 million Americans live with pets they're allergic to as well. When I began to research these statistics, it was clear to me it was time to start cleansing my lungs in order to combat the toxic environment that we cannot escape, but that we can fight back against. Made with organic and wild cultivated herbs and manufactured in the USA, the new InfoWars Life Lung Cleanse is here in a convenient spray bottle that can be brought with you throughout any toxic environment. Now available exclusively at InfoWarsLife.com or by calling toll-free 888-253-3139.
From his Central Texas Command Center, deep behind enemy lines, the information war continues. It's Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
Welcome back to the Alex Jones Show. I'm David Knight, and I'm joined right now by Dr. Peter Breggin. Now, as an introduction, reading from his bio here, since 1964, he's been publishing peer-reviewed articles and medical books in his subspecialty of clinical psychopharmacology. This is someone who has clearly spoken out for a very long time, was at the forefront of telling people about the harmful, counterproductive effects of SSRI drugs, how it was driving people to suicide and to mass murder. And we have been trying to tell people for the longest time that the common link in all these mass shootings are the drugs. And yet the big pharmaceutical companies and the media that feed off of the big pharmaceutical companies, look at how many of the commercials are paid for by big pharmaceutical companies. Of course, they're not going to bite the hand that feeds them. But we've been trying to tell people what's behind that. But I also wanted to talk to Dr. Breggin about lobotomies, high-tech lobotomies that DARPA is working on, because he's been someone who's been at the forefront of pushing back against that. And as we see veterans doing many, many tours in Afghanistan and Iraq, as we see now that that is starting to fire up again. We were just talking to Paul Joseph Watson about how We see this mission creep now in terms of it was first not going to be any troops sent back to Iraq. Now it's going to be 300. Now Obama's saying 500. Now we're getting emails from people saying their entire unit is being trained for deployment within the next few months going back to Iraq. So it looks as they're going to continue to escalate that, continue to keep Afghanistan going on for decades. And so we have a lot of veterans who are suffering from PTSD. And we understand that in the aftermath of World War II, the VA and was treating people with, vets who came back with PTSD, they were treating a lot of them with lobotomies. And now we see that DARPA says that they're going to be able to use brain chips to selectively remove memories. And of course, as you start reaching for something to make you wake up from this nightmare when you hear that the government is going to start messing with people's memories, implanting false memories, removing other memories, when that starts to scare you, they say, oh, don't worry. This is for PTSD. And of course, we heard that with lobotomies. And Dr. Breggin was very much a part of the fight in the 1970s in an international campaign to stop the resurgence of lobotomies. And so I wanted to ask him first about that. Dr. Breggin, thank you for joining us.
Thank you, David. This could be a very important show. It's the first time that I'm going to be talking about DARPA. Thank you. Thanks to you. And I have just a huge amount of background on this. This isn't the first time that government agencies have funded what is essentially mind control. Mm-hmm. Back in the 1970s, the Justice Department and the National Institute of Mental Health, quite a combination, funded psychosurgery at Harvard, where they were implanting electrodes into the brains of people that were supposed to be patients but were experimental subjects. They were stimulating parts of the brain. They were obliterating parts of the brain by heating the electrodes. They had people walking around the ward being stimulated without their knowing it by remote control. Mm. And one of the heroes of DARPA is a fellow named Jose Delgado, who was sort of the godfather of these Harvard programs. And I conducted an international campaign that actually shut down the Harvard program. And I'm proud to say I actually drove Jose Delgado back to Spain back in the early 70s. So this is an old goal. Then we had the CIA. So we moved from the Justice Department and NIMH to the CIA, funding experiments in Canada with D.E. Cameron, who was a very famous psychiatrist. Even though a Canadian, he was at one point the president of our American Psychiatric Association. He had CIA funds to treat people when he was actually obliterating their memories with shock treatment, then using recorded devices to try to reprogram people and redevelop their personalities. Now, in both these projects, what they really succeeded in doing was destroying the brains of people and destroying their lives. Hmm. The final, this just to sum up with the final version of all of this that I got involved with was the Violence Initiative in 1994. My wife and I wrote a book about it called The War Against Children of Color. We found out that the federal government, starting with all of the health agencies, the Justice Department, and the Centers for Disease Control, that these organizations were getting were applying for huge federal funding as a group to go into America's inner cities to identify genetically and biochemically why little children in the inner cities would grow up to become violent. This was pure racism, and it was pure eugenics, which is the usual combination.
Yes.
And Ginger and I worked, you know, for several years to stop that program too. So this is now a reincarnation on a somewhat more sophisticated level,
yes,
of mind control, and the government's been at this for ages.
But of course, we don't have to worry about it now because it's so high tech. You know, it's like the way they sold the drone strikes, saying they were going to do surgical strikes, and yet we see entire wedding parties being taken out. I mean, it's still not a surgical strike. And if they say they're going to be able to go in and selectively mess with people's minds because they've now got some kind of brain chip, you know, a semiconductor that they can use as opposed to doing surgery. It is no less destructive. People need to understand that, you know, you can kill people from a bomb out of a B-52, or you can kill them from a Predator drone. You can destroy their minds with a lobotomy surgery, or you can destroy their minds with a high-tech brain chip. And you're talking about the minorities. We just recently had a report about a government agency funding research on premature babies, varying the amount of oxygen to them and giving some of them too much oxygen, making them...